Hello everyone, welcome to Stanford Online English. Well friends, many times students ask me question that how they can speak fluently. Then they tell me so many problems like they have no atmosphere to speak English and they have no partner to speak English with. Well, after searching a lot, after talking to so many of my students and as per my personal experience, I have selected top 10 ways which can help you in speaking English fluently. So, if you can speak English but not fluently, and if you want to speak English fluently, then I suggest you that watch this video till end, and I'm sure that you will find it quite useful. And if you follow these techniques, then you'll be able to speak English fluently. So, without wasting time, let's start. The first thing I want to tell you is, if you want to speak English fluently, then first of all, you have to learn how to listen carefully and regularly. So how it helps, friends? So first of all, you have to decide that what to listen. See, as you know, only a good listener can be a good speaker. So if you want to speak English fluently, first of all, you have to improve your listening skill. So what can you listen to improve your listening skill? First of all, you can listen to English speaking people. Who are these English speaking people? Well, they can be your friends, they can be your colleagues who speak in office. And if you don't have any person who speaks in English, then you can listen to English news. You should make it a habit to listen to English news, and there is no need to spare extra time for that. You know, you can listen to English news while having your breakfast or while having your lunch or dinner. So you can make it a habit, and then it will be really useful to you. Next thing is, you can listen to English videos on YouTube. As you are watching and listening to this video, YouTube is a great source of knowledge nowadays. So you can choose your favorite channel, and you can continuously watch the videos on that channel, and it can help you in improving your listening. Next point is that you can listen to English movies and serials. Well, if you like to watch English movies and if you like to watch English serials, then you can, you know, download a movie in your laptop, or you can choose any serial and you can regularly follow that serial. So this can also help you in understanding, in improving your listening power. The next thing is to listen to English stories. You know, stories never let us get bored. So they are quite interesting. So we can spend longer time while listening to the stories. So I suggest you that you can watch English stories on YouTube, or maybe you can get a DVD and you can watch it on your laptop. So it can really help you in improving your listening as well as speaking. The next thing is listening to English songs. Well, listening to English songs is one of the things which people think it's difficult and we can't understand English news. But according to me, if you see the lyrics, if you download the lyrics from Google, and then you will find the words which are used in English songs are quite simple. Just because of the style of the singer, this seems difficult. So I suggest you that listen to English songs on a regular basis. Like while you are having bath, you play the songs. You no need to waste separate time for that. And if you listen to English songs regularly, after a few days, you'll be habitual, and that can be really helpful to you. Okay, now the most important part is that how to listen. Some people say that I watched a movie, but I didn't understand anything, so I cannot follow it again. So I suggest you how to, listen. Listening is also an art, so you should listen attentively. Suppose that you are watching English news, so listen to English news quite attentively and carefully. And the most important part is that if you listen anything, you have to listen it regularly, and you have to repeat the topics. For example, if you like any video on YouTube, so what you do, just follow that video multiple times. I myself watched videos so many times. So when you watch videos multiple times, you get the correct pronunciation of the words, and after that you are able to understand that proper video and story, and then you can tell it to others. So that can in that way help you in improving your fluency. So how listening helps us in improving our fluency? So it's like that. When you listen to the people, then second step comes. When you listen people or video or audios, then you have to imitate the English speakers. What is the meaning of imitate? Imitate means copy. Not only copy, just copy and copy the style of the speakers. So if you listen to any English news, to copy the style of that news reader. If you watch any English movie, then speak in the same style. And this is a very good exercise. Okay, so how to imitate? Try to repeat what you listen in English from the fluent English speakers. Okay, and try to imitate their way of pronunciation. How can you imitate the pronunciation? You suppose that you watch a story. So you watch a story with subtitles. Subtitle means the words which are written on the screen while you are listening to the story. So you first play story 2 or 3 times. After that, what you do? Just repeat those pronunciation in the same styles. So suppose that story is for 15 minutes. So you will have a 15 minutes practice. And that is very, very important. You have no partner to speak with. But if you practice that story or movie, take the example of movie. Movie is for 1.5 hours at least. So watch, download a movie in your laptop. Watch it 2 or 3 times. And then when you're free on Sunday and Saturday, just with the subtitles, speak it continuously for 1 or 1.5 hours. You will speak English continuously for 1 or 1.5 hours. That will twist your tongue and that will make your tongue fluent. You already know basic English, so that will really help you in that case. So this is the second thing you can do. And next tip is very, very important. That is speak in front of the mirror. You know, even Amitabh said that before he go for, you know, acting, he just practice in front of the mirror. Because, you know, it is said that you can face the world if you can face yourself in the mirror. It's a very good exercise for confidence building. Because when you practice in front of the mirror, then you feel confident. It is like that you are talking to someone else. So how to practice in front of the mirror? Choose a speech or general conversation and act as if you are talking to someone else. And try to speak as loud as you can. Okay, for example, you have to go for interview. You know the common interview questions. Okay, tell me about yourself and why do you want to leave this job. So you practice these questions in front of mirror, and that will be a very good practice. And when you practice, then maybe you can lock yourself in the room and speak as loud as you can. This is one of the best practice. Everyone suggests about it. I myself have done it. So I suggest you just do it and it will really help you in improving your fluency. The next point is record your voice. Well, if you complain that you have no partner to speak English with, then I say your mobile can be your best speaking partner. What you have to do, record your speech or conversation in your mobile, then listen to the recording and catch your mistakes. In case you are not able to catch your mistake, then what you do, that just ask someone else to correct you and, you know, correct your mistakes. It can be a friend or teacher. And after that, you know, there are so many things you can record in your mobile. You can record your speech, you can record your conversation, or you can record commentaries. Some people like to play cricket. So while you watch cricket match, just you do commentary and record that commentary in your mobile phone. Okay. And you can just, you know, that will help you really. And you can also try to make video recordings. If you have a smartphone, then you make video recording because it will catch your gestures and it will help you in improving your body language while you speak. So recording voice is another very good exercise. The next thing is dial customer care number. Because as we all are using mobile, how it helps, I just tell you. So this exercise is best if you can speak a little and don't have any partner to practice with. Okay, as I told you, students say that they don't have any partner to speak English with. So what you can do, just dial the customer care number and ask a lengthy question, rather lengthy question like mobile portability or postpaid to prepaid. How can I change my connection from postpaid to prepaid? So it's a really good exercise you can do. Okay, what will happen? The customer, the person who is there, he will explain that how can you do it, and that will be a live practice of speaking English. The next point is that visit the shopping malls. So if you have any shopping mall nearby, then you know there are so many advanced shops there. So just go to any shop and start conversation in English, and you know the salesperson there are very cooperative because you are customer, so they will not tell you that what is your mistake. So you can freely talk with them, okay, and you can have actual experience there. And while they speak, you can listen to their pronunciation, their body language very carefully. So that can also be very helpful. Next is teach someone if possible. Well, if you have some knowledge about English and you want to be more fluent, then this is one of the best way. What you do, just find someone who knows less English than you and then train him. Maybe you can train him for free. So in the weekends, you can train. Teaching is the best way to practice anything. If you teach, then you get very nice practice and you can speak English fluently. The next thing is learn daily use vocabularies. Well, you cannot speak English fluently if you have no knowledge about personalities, crimes, sports, politics, household articles, diseases, basic verbs, routine verbs. So if you don't know the vocabularies, how can you speak fluently? So first I suggest that you must improve your basic vocabularies. You should know how these words are called, okay? And if you don't know, then really it's difficult to improve your English. The next is read loudly. Some people feel that it is not possible to improve fluency while reading. But I tell you that you can definitely improve your fluency by reading. How? You should read newspaper, magazines, kids' storybooks, comics, novels, etc. But read loudly. Don't read, while keeping your mouth shut. You should speak loudly. You should read loudly. And how it helps? Suppose that you are reading a novel. And there are two characters. So first you change tone and speak in one character's voice. Then you change your voice again and speak in another character's voice. If you are if you are reading a story, do the same activity and speak it loudly. So it will be like you are talking with two people and words are already written. So it will be very nice practice. And also if you want to improve further, you can note down the words or sentence structures. But read regularly. It is very important. Next is practice on mobile apps. This is one of the modern technique. Okay, there are so many apps which can help you, like Hello English. It's quite popular app. Or you can simply go on Google Play and write that English speaking apps and you will find so many apps there. So download the apps and those apps help you in improving your fluency. They ask